This project's been back and forth for years at this point. But right now we're in a crucial two-week window where people can try to push back against this plan and suggest changes they think will benefit our area.
This is step one. This is to make sure our community understand what's at stake, to make sure they become engaged, to make sure their voices are heard, because they need to pick up the phone, they need to email, and let the colonel know exactly why it's important to their area.
Today, Chairman of the Lee County Commission, Kevin Ruane, submitted a counterproposal to the current tentative plan.
My job is to advocate and educate the community so we're one voice, obviously advocating for the change that's necessary.
And those changes are primarily focused on limiting how much water is funneled our way during the rainy season, and also where that water flow is measured from. So right now, under the current proposal, the flow is measured closer to Lake Okeechobee. Ruane and his team think it should be measured at Franklin Lock and Dam farther downstream.
Think about last night. Think about today. We had rain. Our watershed gets full.
And how much of that water makes its way into the Caloosahatchee between Lake O and the lock, that can really throw off the flow numbers.
We want to be measured the same way at S79 at the Franklin Locks to include our watershed. So then the scientists can calculate what we're receiving. We don't have to guess.
His end goal is to avoid another 2018, what he calls the perfect storm, where heavy flows to the Caloosahatchee contributed to toxic algae outbreaks in southwest Florida.
If this gets rammed down our throat with really no modifications or a slight modification, we will legally challenge this. We will file the necessary papers to challenge what is wrong about this and make it right.
The public comment period ends August 5th, so now is the time to make your voice heard. Once this plan is finalized, it'll be the guidebook for how things are handled for the next decade. I'm Chris Redfern, NBC2.